like, yeah. What? I'm glad.
Yes, I know.
To see you.
Yeah, we came to make you happy.
Mm-hmm.
We went to the bus so all of us could come and see you.
When you're weary, and feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. I'm on your side. Oh, when times get rough and friends just scared, can't be found like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay troubled water, I will lay me down. When you're down and low, when you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your part. When darkness comes and fate is all around, like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay troubled water, I will lay me down. I'll take your part. Oh, when darkness comes and pain is all around, like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down. Troubled water, I will lay me down.
There's a lot of last names here in this room. There's one house. It all started with one name, and that name is Morvant. Can everybody say Morvant one time? Thank you. I don't know if any other family could pull this off. There's something about the Morvants. You know what I'm saying? Can I get an amen?
All right, this morning we are just so elated and sad to do this for many of us again. But I think it's joyful that we're all together. We have every single downline here. But Uncle Andrew is the one who made this happen by just asking to be placed in the land where he grew up. And celebration yesterday and today, this portion of the of our time together is very meaningful. And so we thank each and every one of you for coming. We are not only going to honor Uncle Andrew's wishes, we're also going to place him with his brother Uncle George and his cousin Mervyn. And as was shared, as you learned, Mervyn used to come to this same spot
every Sunday.
And so this is fitting for this to happen and meaningful. So at this time, Kara has some very special words she wants to share. And so we'll give her the opportunity.
The uncles have laid down their dominoes for Mervyn, Andrew, and George. We no longer fear for the wood of the tabletop. No longer listen for the crack of tile at the end of play. The uncles have laid down their dominoes. Their thick-bottomed glasses are empty now. The ice melts slow into amber, the last dredges of rum. No longer do we look to the rafters of the basement ceiling, listening for their burst of laughter. It is silent. The old calypsos are muted now. They no longer ripple the cotton of speakers, no longer rattle the carobs in their case. The game has ended. There is no more mass to play. There is no more parade. We will never beat them at chess. It is time to turn down the thermostat. The cold of our winters no longer sits on their bones. A new sun shines on them now. It bakes the earth they sprung from as they feed the roots of the mango tree. Their slippers sit empty. And when we slip our own young feet in them, we find them loose. We cannot walk. It is time now for us to pull from the table the chairs where they played, heavy with absence. Take our seats where our respective fathers sat, or will sit not much longer. Take up the tiles, turn the stereo up. The uncles have laid down their dominoes, retired back to the dashikis and afros of youth, pipes and crushed cigarettes in shirt jack pockets, Sunday shoes slung around their young necks. They are barefoot now, kicking a football up Pelican Street, where our shoes stamp sadly, thinking only of our loss, but they have never been more beautiful.